So today is an exciting day. Well, it's not very exciting. It's actually really horrible weather in Toronto right now. So not that exciting, but so I'm training legs today and I decided why not film it for YouTube because I've been slacking on YouTube a little bit. So I'm just gonna honestly film my entire routine. You're gonna see how I activate my glutes. Yeah, this is just exactly what I'm gonna be doing. I'm gonna try and play some music in the background and let's get started. So I'm gonna try and explain a few things as I'm doing it. As always, ladies, when we're training glutes, we do wanna activate our glutes. We're gonna be doing a little bit of an activation circuit to start and then we'll get right into the workout. And then, yeah, should be fun. So we're first gonna start off with activating our glutes. It's really important to wake up those glutes. For me right now, it's pretty early in the morning. I was just sleeping, so my glutes have not been woken up or activated whatsoever, so it's really important to wake them up. So I'm gonna be using my peach bands. This resistance is really, really heavy, so I really like these bands a lot and their fabric so they don't slip off. If you guys are interested in getting peach bands, I can give you 10% off with my code. Just use the code Gina. Let's get started. So we're gonna put the band above our knees. And so what I'm gonna be doing is I'm going to be squatting, push out, come back up. Squatting, push out, come back up. All right, let's get started. I'm going to do 12. I can't blast my music because I'm scared of copyright, so I'm really sorry. One. Next up, I'll lower the camera. So keep the band above your knees. We're gonna lie down and we're just gonna be doing 25 glute bridges in 3, 2, 1. 1, 2. Now it's really important that you keep your knees apart. You're pushing against the band the entire time. 6, 7, 8. Push down on your palms. I sometimes forget. 10, 11, squeezing those glutes as hard as you can at the top. 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, press on those heels. 18, 19, 20, you got 5 more. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Beautiful. Now we're gonna keep the bands above our knees. Okay, I'll switch it around. We're gonna go into tabletop position. If you're not sure how to do this, I have a glute activation YouTube video that you guys can follow along and it shows this specific glute activation exercise. Hands are forward and you're gonna go into a tabletop position, squeezing those glutes. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, keep going, 8, 9, 10, squeezing those glutes as tight as you can. This is 3, 4, keep pushing, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, again, last one, beautiful. So 20 of those. Take a second, and then we're gonna start right from the top when it comes to our squats. Knees in and out. Let's do it. Band back on. Second set. We're gonna squat and spread those knees apart. 2. Really spread them apart as far as you can. The resistance on this band is really tight, but I can definitely feel it in my glutes. 8, 9, keep pushing. 10, beautiful. Last one, I'm laughing at myself. Okay, and 1, 2, three, four. Squeezing your glutes as tight as you can, and you really want to spread those knees apart. You're pushing against the band. Eight, nine, 10. Did this song fucking repeat? It did. God damn it. 12, 13, nice and high. 14, 15, 16, 17, nice and high. 18, 19, 20. Five more. 5, 4, 3, 2, last one, nice and high. Good. Beautiful. Now, get into tabletop. I don't know why I'm switching sides, just preference, I guess. 1, spreading those knees apart. 2, 3, 4. I'm gonna do 20, nice and high. Good job. If you feel the burn, that's a good fucking sign, ladies. I'm shaking a bit. This is 10. 2. Keep going. 3. 4. 5. 6. 7. 8. 9. 20. Sorry, I count a little weird, but. Alright, second set's done. Let me just change this repetitive song. All right, ladies, one more set, and then we'll get right into it. Get ready, put your band on. 3, 2, 1, let's do 12. Squat, spread. 1, 2, 3, 4. And it's really important to try and engage your core while you're doing this. So keep your stomach really tight, which means pretend like someone is literally about to punch you. This is 10, 11, 12. Beautiful. I'm just gonna turn down the brightness. It's a little, she's a little bright today. It is 1, 2, nice and high. 3, 4, pushing those knees apart. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, keep pushing, 10, 11, 12, keep squeezing. Even at the bottom, you're squeezing. It's a hard thing to do, but I always tell my clients, pretend there's a credit card in between your bum cheeks, and you don't want to let it go. I lost count, but I think this is 18, 19, last one, nice and high, 20. Good job. All right, ladies, right away, get into that tabletop position. And go. 1, 2. Don't let your bum touch the floor. 5. Spread those knees apart. 6. Squeezing your glutes. 8. 9. 10. Keep pushing. 12, oh my God. 13, squeezing, squeezing. 14, pushing against the band. 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Beautiful. Well done, ladies. Have some water. You deserve it. First up, to open up our hips. So we're sitting. Let me fix the camera. Look how funny I look right now. Sitting on your feet, your hand is gonna go behind you. You're lifting up your hips and making a giant circle. So as you lift up your hips, you're squeezing your glutes, big circle to the other side. Switch, squeezing those glutes. You're gonna feel it in your quads as well. But this is a really good way to open up your hips a little bit. Big circle. Keep going. I love this because it also kind of feels like a stretch. Oh, sometimes you can hear my bones crack. Let's do 3 more. 1. Open up and breathe. Good. Be very proud of yourselves for doing this for you. This is all for you. Again, let's do it. One. Also, I want to know where you guys live. This is three. Is it warm where you guys are? Because in Toronto right now,
it is ugly.
You do not want to be in Toronto right now, let me tell you that. Really open up, squeezing those glutes. You're gonna feel it in your quads. Big circle, really open up. We got three more. One. Two, last one, ladies. Three, beautiful. Next. Okay, the next exercise.
Excuse me.
All right, if you guys have dumbbells, lovely. If you don't, you can just do these exercises extra slow, and you could also use the items around the house. So wine bottles are fantastic. I used to use those when I didn't have any dumbbells. What else could you use? I don't know, be creative. I'm sure you guys have heavier items, you know? So we're doing some glute bridges. But we're doing them weighted. So I'm putting the bands above, ow! Above my knee. Always want that extra resistance. Putting the weight on my pelvis. Feet are spread apart. Come up, squeezing those glutes. Come down a little slow, spreading those knees apart. And come right back up again. I don't like to put my entire butt right on the mat. I like keeping that tension throughout the entire movement. So try not to completely rest like this and then come back up. You wanna keep your bum off the ground by keeping it tight and squeezing it the entire time. So I believe this is 7, 8, I'm using 25 pounds, 9. See how slow I'm going? I'm not speeding it up. Beautiful, nice and high. Think about your glutes the whole time. This is 14. 15, 16, 17, squeeze, 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 19, last one, 20. Beautiful, put to the side, short rests, deep breaths, well done. All right, ladies, let's do it.
Yay, okay.
Grab your dumbbell. Let's do it. One, two, nice and high. Three, four, five, six, seven, knees apart. 10, 11, 12, spread your knees apart, I always forget. 14, 15, 16, nice and high. 17, 18, 19, last one. Oh my God. Okay. My mom is starting to cry a little. She's not happy. But later she will be happy in a fucking thong bikini, okay? Let's do it. Last set. Nice and high. And one. Two. Three, nice and high. Four, five, spreading those knees apart, don't forget. Ten. This is 12, sorry, keep forgetting to count. 13, 14, 15, 16, holy shit. Holy shit, talkie mushrooms! 19, last one. Oh my God, my ass is literally on fire. This song! I'll lower the music. So with your squats, you want to make sure your legs are a bit wider than hip width apart. So I'm going to have two dumbbells in front of me like this. I'm in a wide stance squat. Dumbbells are in front of me. Chest is up. Shoulders are back. And I'm squatting down, pushing my hips back. See? Up. One. Two. Push my hips back. Three. Four. Five. Six. Push your hips back. Seven. Eight. Nine. 10. 11. Last one. 12. Deep breath. My head's cut off, but you don't need to see my head. You just need to watch my hips. I love squatting because it's a really good compound exercise that literally works your entire body. It works your core, obviously your legs, your glutes, your calves. Just the ultimate best compound movement other than maybe deadlifts, but they're both up there for me. Alright, let's do it again. Grab your dumbbells and pushing those hips back. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Really push them back. Six. Seven. Keeping that chest up. Eight. Squeeze your glutes the whole time. Nine. Try and squeeze at the bottom. So squeeze right here, squeeze right here. 10. 11. Last one. Beautiful. Take a breath. Well done. So I used to work at a restaurant, and this song played all the time. And it's so good. Let's do it. Three, two, one. One, two, three, four, whew, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, two more. Last one. Good job. Next up, RDLs. When it comes to your RDLs, you want to push back your hips as far as you can. It's a hinge movement. So you're hinging from the hips. What a lot of people do with RDLs is that they kind of use their knees to lower themselves or their upper back to lower themselves. You want to use your hips to lower yourself. And then when you're down right below your knee, by your shins pretty much, you want to hinge forward with your hip. See how I'm hinging forward? And your knees, just a slight bend. Don't lock them and don't overbend them. It's a very slight bend. When you reach the bottom, you come up, hinge forward. Dumbbells forward, chest up, shoulders back, hinging my hips back. Once I reach the bottom, come up, squeeze. And I'm squeezing my glutes the whole time, not just at the top. Two. Nice and slow. Three. See how I'm not rushing it? Four. Five. Six, seven, eight, sorry, I can't count, nine, 10, 11, last one here, me trying to like make my YouTube video more interesting. Distractions. Let's grab our dumbbells again And let's go for it, ladies. Pushing those hips back, chest up, shoulders back, slowly lowering those dumbbells. And come back up, squeezing those glutes. Squeezing them at all times, and squeezing them right here. Think about it, it's a mind to muscle thing. So it's not easy to do. And you're gonna find like, I'm not doing it, I'm not squeezing my glutes. But if you think about it, you actually are. Think right here, squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. Up, that's five. Six, keep the dumbbells close to you. They're almost sliding off your legs. Whew, I believe this is seven. Eight. Keep pushing. Nine. Ten. Two more. Done. Take a break. If you find that you are feeling lower back pain when you're doing these, A, your form's not right. B, the weight is too heavy. Foam roll your lower back, do those back stretches, work on your mobility, because with deadlifts, you need that hip mobility. A lot of people can only go this far and then their back compensates, or this far and their knees compensate. You want to be able to have that full range of motion in your hips. So you have to work on your hip mobility. Grab your dumbbells. Dumbbells in front of you, chest up, shoulders back. And slowly go down. One. Two. Where's the music? Oh, this is a sad song, but it's fine. This is four. Pushing those hips back, ladies, remember. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Guys, I can't sing. Nine. Then I start yelling, okay. 10. 11. Last one. 12. Good job. I'm actually gonna do four sets of these. I used to be able to deadlift some pretty heavy weight back in the day when we had our gyms. I definitely feel a lot weaker than I used to. I like to do extra sets. I like to really slow down my exercises because I feel my muscles way more stimulated when I slow it down. So yeah, you gotta make it work when you don't have the heavy weights. So deep breaths. I'm gonna do one more set. Last set, grab those dumbbells. Okay, chest up, shoulders back, and your feet are right underneath your shoulders. Pushing my hips back nice and slow. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Almost done. Nine. Ten. Push, push, push. Last one here. It's in a bun now. Okay. With a split squat, your foot is behind you and your chest is up, your shoulders are back. I'm gonna be holding a dumbbell right in front of me. I'm gonna be pushing my hip back to activate this glute, and then I'm gonna push off my heel. One. You wanna keep this leg very, very light. Don't put too much weight on it. Push my hips back. One. I'm gonna do 21 pounds. I just hold it in front of me like so. So, one foot behind you, keeping it very, very light. Just like so. Pushing my hips back. And we're gonna do 12. One. Two. Three. Remember, I'm pushing off my right leg right now. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. Ten. Holy fuck. Good. Last one here. Next leg. Chest up. Shoulders back. Pushing my hips back. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Holy fuck. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. Ten. Two more. Last one. Push. Good. Oh, those are fucking horrible.
Listen, just give me a second. I don't want to do this.
I don't want to do this exercise. When I don't like to do something, to me, that means there's a weakness there. I don't like doing Bulgarians because there's a weakness there. I'm not great at them. So I have to work on them to eventually start to like them. I hated burpees. I used to hate them so much, but I kept doing them, and now I'm actually kind of starting to like, I like them. They're kind of fun. So we gotta work on our weaknesses. Say fuck my life, say fuck you to the dumbbell. Do whatever you need to do to let that anger out, but let's do it, okay? One foot behind you. So slowly go down, keeping that back leg light. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. Whew. Ten. 11. Last one. Beautiful. All right, ladies, next leg. Okay. Get ready. Pushing your hips back. And one. Focusing on that front leg. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. 10. Make sure your knee doesn't touch the ground. Sometimes that happens by accident. Last one. Beautiful. Fine. Keep pushing, ladies. We're almost done. Okay. Dumbbells in front of you. Slowly come down. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Eight. Nine. Whew. Ten. Last one. Make sure you're inhaling coming down, exhaling when you come up. Okay. Let's go. Last one. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. Whew. Ten. 11. 12. Good job, ladies. We're done with those. All right, ladies. All right, you guys. So the next exercise is called reverse hypers. You don't need a bench to do it. You can actually do it on your mat. But if you're just on the ground, kind of think of it as like a Superman without your arms up. We're going to put a band above our knee so we can get that extra resistance. So pretty much, you want to lie down on your bench. You can hug it. Sometimes I hold it like this. And pretty much the very end of my private area is on the end of the bench. That's the best way I can describe it. So you're gonna hug the bench. Your feet are up. You kind of look like a frog. I don't know if this looks like a frog actually, but. So I'm gonna rest my head. My knees are pushing against the band. You're going to lift your legs up, squeezing those glutes as tight as you can. Very slowly come down, making sure your knees are still spreading apart nice and slow. So that's two, three. Try and use your glutes to get yourself up. 3. 4. 5.
Holy fuck.
6. 7. 8. I'm just gonna turn this way because I can't imagine my face right now. 9. 10. 11. 12. I honestly think this exercise is the most fucked up exercise for your ass. No joke. I just feel it instantly. First rep. It's just insanity. But we don't want to rest for too long. Okay? I'm trying to get this. I don't know about you guys, but I always try to get my workouts over with, so I try and rest as minimal as possible. Fuck. Get ready. Using your glutes, making sure your core is planted on to the bench. 3. I'm using my glutes to come up. 4. Fuck. 5. 6. Oh my god, I almost peed myself there. Holy shit. 7. 8. 9. 10. 11. Last one. Jesus fucking Christ, I'm gonna cry. Okay, deep breaths. We're almost done. Breathe in 3, 2, 1. 1. Whew. Whew. 2, 3, 4, 5. Ugh. Sorry, fuck. I can't control my noises. 8. 10. 11. Fuck, shit, asshole. Damn it. Okay. We're done with those. Oh my Jesus. We're doing jump squats. You're gonna jump, you land in a squat, and you make sure when you land, you're pretty much parallel to the floor, and then you shoot back up again. So I'll show you what it looks like. Pushing my hips back, big jump, land, land. All right, I'm gonna aim for 15. Let's fucking go. 3, 2, 1, 1, 2, 3. Pushing against the band, 5, 6, 7. Squeezing your bum at the top, don't forget. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Take a short rest. Short rest, short rest. Okay. 3, 2, 1. Up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Squeeze your glutes. 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Woo! Okay. In 5, 4, 3, 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Ladies, we're done. So, that angle. This is a very nice, short, effective glute leg workout. You know, you do all your compounds, you do your isolation, you do your activation, and you finish off with a plyometric exercise, which is jump squats. Great workout, didn't take me very long. You can always make it a bit more challenging. You can add more sets. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this workout. I'm definitely gonna be posting more of these. If you guys did enjoy, please make sure to subscribe to your girl if you haven't already. And if you did enjoy it, please give this video a thumbs up and a comment as well, because I love my comments. If you guys did this workout, good job. I'm so fucking proud of you, as always. Yay!